Namaste. Myself, Dr. Basaraj M. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video, I explain the solution of ordinary linear differential equation by Laplace transform method. Learning outcomes. At the end of this session, student will be able to solve the ordinary linear differential equation by Laplace transform method. Pause the video and write the answer for the question, that is, what is the partial fraction of x upon x plus 1 into x plus 5? I hope all of you have written the answer. Solution: x upon x plus 1 into x plus 5. Now here, in the denominator, both are the linear factor, can be separated by the partial fraction as a upon x plus 1 plus b upon x plus 5. Now, on taking LCM and simplifying, which is equal to a into x plus 5 plus b into x plus 1 upon x plus 1 into x plus 5. On the cross multiplication, which becomes x is equal to a into x plus 5 plus b into x plus 1. Call it is equation 1. Now, find the value of a and b here. Now, to find the value of a, you have to choose the value of x such that the coefficient of b becomes 0. That is, the x plus 1 is equal to 0. It means the x is equal to minus 1. Put x is equal to minus 1. That minus 1 is equal to 4a, which is a is equal to minus 1 by 4. Now, similarly, suppose you have to find the value of b, you have to choose the value of x such that the coefficient of a becomes 0. What is the coefficient of a? That is x plus 5. They make it is x plus 5 is equal to 0, implies x is equal to minus 5. That is, put x is equal to minus 5. That is, equation 1 implies minus 5 is equal to minus 4b, which implies b is equal to 5 by 4. Therefore, the x upon x plus 1 to x plus 5, which is equal to minus 1 by 4 upon x plus 1 plus 5 by 4 upon x plus 5. Now come to an example. Solve dqy upon dt cube plus d2y upon dt squared minus dy by dt minus y is equal to 0. Given y of 0 is equal to 0, which is equal to y dash of 0, and y double dash of 0 is equal to 6 by using the Laplace transform method. Solution: the given differential equation can be written as y triple dash of t plus y double dash of t minus y dash of t minus y of t is equal to 0. Call it is equation 1. The given initial conditions are y of 0 is equal to y dash of 0, which is equal to 0, and y double dash of 0 is equal to 6. Call it is equation number 6. Taking the Laplace transform on both sides to equation 1, we get L of y triple dash of t plus y double dash of t minus y dash of t minus y of t is equal to 0. By linearity property, the above equation can be written as L of y triple dash of t plus L of y double dash of t minus L of y dash of t minus L of y of t is equal to 0. By Laplace transform derivative, we know that L of y triple dash of t is equal to s cube into L of y of t minus s squared into y of 0 minus s into y dash of 0 minus y double dash of 0. L of y double dash of t is equal to s squared into L of y of t minus s into y of 0 minus y dash of 0. L of y dash of t is equal to s into L of y of t minus y of 0. Call it is equation number 4. Substituting the equation 4 in equation 3, we get s cube into L of y of t minus s squared into y of 0 minus s into y dash of 0 minus y double dash of 0 plus s squared into L of y of t minus s into y of 0 minus y dash of 0 minus s into L of y of t plus y of 0 minus L of y of t is equal to 0. Using the equation 2 in the above equation and simplifying, we get s cube plus s squared minus s minus 1 into L of y of t is equal to 6. S cube plus s squared minus s minus 1 into L of y of t is equal to 6. Now, further, for simplification, the coefficient of L of y of t can be split as the its linear factor. For that, s squared into s plus 1 minus 1 into s plus 1 into L of y of t is equal to 6. That is, s plus 1 is the further common. That becomes s squared minus 1 into s plus 1 into L of y of t is equal to 6. Therefore, L of y of t is equal to 6 upon s minus 1 into s plus 1 whole squared. Now, taking the inverse Laplace transform on both sides, we get y of t is equal to L inverse of 6 upon s minus 1 into s plus 1 whole squared. Call it is equation 5. For taking the inverse of this function, we have to separate these linear factors. For the case, consider 6 upon s minus 1 into s plus 1 whole squared. Now, these linear factors, two linear factors, can be separated by using the partial fraction. In the denominator, one is the non-repeated linear factor, and there is a repeated twice. That becomes a upon s minus 1 plus b upon s plus 1 plus c upon s plus 1 whole squared. Call it is equation 6, where a, b, c are constant to be determined. That is, now on taking the LCM on the right hand side on the cross multiplication, it becomes 6 is equal to a into s plus 1 whole squared plus b into s plus 1 into s minus 1 plus c into s minus 1. Call it is equation number 7. Now, where ABC are the constant to determine. Now, suppose you have to find the value of A. To make choose the value of A such that the coefficient of B and C become 0. Now, how to choose that one? Which the factor is a common in the both? That is s minus 1. In the both coefficient of B as well as coefficient of C. Now, put S is equal to 1 in equation 7. We get A is equal to 6 by 4 is equal to 3 by 2. Now, similarly, we have to put S is equal to minus 1 in equation 7. We get that is 6 is equal to C into minus 2, which is equal to C is equal to minus 6 by 2 is equal to minus 3. Now, to find the value of the B, we have to put S is equal to 0 in equation 7. We get 6 is equal to A minus B minus C. This is B is equal to A minus C minus 6 implies B is equal to minus 3 by 2. Substitute the value of ABC in equation 6, we get 6 upon S minus 1 into S plus 1 whole squared, which is equal to 3 by 2 into S minus 1 minus 3 by 2 into S plus 1 minus 3 upon S plus 1 whole squared. Using the above result in equation 5 becomes y of t is equal to L inverse of 3 by 2 into S minus 1 minus 3 by 2 into S plus 1 minus 3 into S plus 1 whole squared. That is, on using the linearity property, that is the right hand side can be written as that is y of t is equal to 3 by 2 into L inverse of 1 upon S minus 1 minus 3 by 2 into L inverse of 1 upon S plus 1 minus 3 into L inverse of 1 upon S plus 1 whole squared, which is equal to 3 by 2 into, but we know that L inverse of 1 upon S minus 1 is equal to e to the power t minus 3 by 2 L inverse of 1 upon S plus 1, which becomes e to the power of minus t minus 3 into e to the power of minus t into L inverse of 1 upon S squared L because by first shifting property. Thus, y of t is equal to 3 is the common in the first two terms, that is 3 into e to the power t minus e to the power of minus t by 2 minus 3 into e to the power of minus t into L inverse of 1 upon s squared is equal to t. Thus, y of t is equal to 3 into sin h t minus 3 into e to the power of minus t into t is the required solution. Higher Engineering Mathematics by HK Das and Engineer Rajnish Verma. Thank you.